Good afternoon. My name is Marina Mikhailovna-Oreskova. I'm author of Petrov Institute, and I will speak about the use of instruments of digital pathology for assessing the results of your studies. As you know, Fisher's fluorescent hybridization cyto, it was developed in the early 1980s. For revealing and localization of specific sequences DNA in chromosomes. This method is extensively used in medicine, particularly in oncopathology, so that is an important and irreplaceable instrument for the pathologist. We classify the samples and diagnostic that make it possible to prove or disapprove WSR, diagnosis prognostic, for instance, and make a neuroblastoma and predictive samples such as HER2 in case of breast cancer. We can also divide the samples into those for in which the precise number of signals in the cell nucleus are important amplification, and the samples in which mutual disposition of the signals are important, break apart samples, and fusion samples. The examples are given in the slide. In this slide, these are stages of sample preparation that result in fluorescent cloths that I won't discuss now. And then what is the fate of fluorescent slide? Using fluorescent microscopy, this glass can be assessed immediately and conclusion can be drawn. I will discuss the stage that following digital pathology after putting the slide under the cover glass. I will give the example of fish HER2 sample, exemplified by breast cancer first. The expert is scanning the slide stained with hematoxylin 1 so that we would understand where in the sample the invasive tumor is present, where carcinoma in situ are the lymphoid infiltrates and normal tissue of the mammary gland. Then the expert is scanning IgH. IgH with HER2 so that we could understand how the slide was covered, what are the zones, probably there is a certain heterogeneity. Then the next stage is scanning of the ready fluorescent specimen in depth, and again while looking at the zones in the specimen, we compare it with IgH scan, and the doctor outlines the zones in which he's interested, because that is a very large specimen with a large area and it cannot be scanned immediately as a whole specimen, because that will be a long-term process and the weight would be great. So the doctor marks the interesting zone and normal tissue in the gland for control, or lymphoid accumulations for control. And as a result, the expert is precisely scanning and filters the zones, which will be later assessed by the doctor. We can also look at the characteristic of the scan, similar to filter characteristics, which we use to scan the specimen, the scanning time, size of image, and the volume, the extent of the work to be done by the doctor, but it was done by the scanner. Here you can see that 1,161 field of vision was scanned at the assessment evaluation period of the specimen. The first thing that we do while looking at the nuclei of the cells, and we outline along the perimeter some nuclei of tumoral cells. We are doing it to distinguish the nuclei of tumoral cells from the sites or carcinoma in situ, to assess the signals within the nuclei of the cell, not outside its limits. At the next stage, we can also include red filter and count the number of red signals and then the number of the green signals. Then it is easily converted to Excel table, and we can see the number of the nucleus of the cells which were counted, the number of the red and green signals, and we can easily calculate the total number of green and red signals, their ratio, and average number of red and green signals in core in cell nuclei that is important for drawing the conclusion. And if the advantage of the digital analysis in respect of the samples for amplification is not as obvious, specimens. These specimens demonstrated precisely. For instance, Fisher SS 18, these are scanned. The scans lie in depth, and at first stage, we mark the cell nuclei. It is more difficult because the nuclei are superimposed, but we can understand where one cell ends and the other cell starts. Then we are analyzing the location and distribution of the red and green signals, and we can include two pseudo colors immediately, simultaneously, and analyze it in terms of break apart. There is a fusion, two signals are in the same place, and there is a break apart. In this cell, we can see a fusion and a break apart. Here, there are two fusions because the distance between the red and the green signal doesn't exceed the diameter of the signal. We convert it into the Excel table. It is much simpler than writing down because the program has to assess 100 tumoral cells, and using the table, we can easily calculate the percentage of the cells with the break apart that we're looking for. As to our experience, in 2019, we carried out 398 fish studies. Most of them, 56%, are samples for HER2, ranking second are BCL7, BCN6, and then USR and SS18. Proceeding from our experience, we can distinguish the advantages, the pros, and the cons of digital analysis. We'll start with pros. First, a more precise calculation of the signals, of the precise number in the core cell nucleus, possibility of simultaneous visualization of all the signals that is important for specimens for break apart and diffusions, a lower load on the eyesight of the doctor, possibility of looking at the scans at any time and any place so you can work remotely, more objective result due to the possibility of simultaneous looking by several doctors on the same cell, so several doctors can do it simultaneously and give their conclusion. Possibility of regulating lighting, color of the signals, and correction of preciseness, and the possibility of creating the database of scans, storage of scans, because the scan can be kept for a limited period of time. You can come back to it if you have some questions. And the database would make it possible to train new specialists. It will be more easily versus the microscope. As to the cons, increase of the time of response, though I think that is a debatable issue because, as I already said, there is a possibility of remote operation or with this, work with the scan. If the scan was taken on a Friday night, you shouldn't wait for Monday to come to your workplace and look at it in the microscope. Second disadvantage, the necessity of a reference. A scanning microscope doesn't mean that you should not use fluorescent microscope, because before you scan the drug, you have to be convinced that the reaction of hybridization has been successful. That's why you need fluorescent microscope. The next disadvantage, increasing cost of emerging to the market, and the agents, the necessity of training specialists in scanning, in analyzing fish studies in the digital version. And the next disadvantage appears non-solved questions that might arise as to how many cells have to be counted, and what cells are suitable for analyzing, and what cells are not fit for analyzing, whether we can analyze the cells with one signal, if that is a sample HER2 and one green signal in the cell, can we regard this cell, can we count this cell, or should we count only cells with two green signals, because they would mean a diploid set of chromosomes. And unfortunately, we don't have experience of working with cytological smears. Possibly there are some problems that can be solved when we use cytological smears. Unfortunately, we don't have such experience. In digital pathology, we have such an option as digital software analysis of the scan, for instance, for the sample for HER2. It is available and can be used if you have an intermediate amplification. You have to train the machine to learn the machine how to search the signals, and it will show you what is the percentage of amplified and non-amplified cells. In my view, that training will take too much time, and it will be quicker to count it manually. And the data which are given by the software are not quite suitable for our conclusions. And what should be done to have a good result, to have a good fish specimen that could be assessed? It is necessary at the stage of cutting to observe the time of cold and warm ischemia of the specimen. It is also important to correctly fix and place the material. You should remember that part of the stains for marking the resection margins can fluoresce themselves, and the fragments that died with them would be not easily assessed and scanned. You should remember that the slides should be thin, 2 or 5 microns, so that there would be one layer of cells. They shouldn't overlap, so that we should identify a specific nuclei on the specimen. You should wash the specimen to remove the remains of the probe to minimize the amount of debris in the scan. And the scanner should, the scan specialist should understand where there are signals and debris and focus on the signals. The scanning zone should cover control. As I've already said, these are lymphocytes or normal tissue cells in which we know how the signals should look and where they should be located relative to each other. At the stage of examining the slides, we count only the cells that were not subject to lysis. They do not look like circular rolls, and we calculate separate cells that are not overlapping, not to increase the artificial number of signals. We're not counting the cells in carcinoma in situ, only cells of invasive cancer. We don't count the cells with one red or green signals. We count the cells only with diploid chromosome set. We have to distinguish tumoral cells from lymphocytes and normal cells. And you have to understand how the signal and the debris look, that the signal is inside the cell, and the debris might be wherever in the intercellular space. And that is probably the end of my presentation. Thank you very much for your attention. Be healthy and have a good morning.